Now that the unit's on, let's have a look at what the lights are telling us. Each of the inputs has its own light. It's automatic. You can see when you plug in that your input is active. And your headphones are down here, and the same is true there. Only Ellie's is lit right now. That means it's the focus of the big knob. So when I turn this up and down, I'm turning Ellie's headphone up and down. Or just by the same token, I could turn my headphones up or down. And the beauty of it is, each of these headphones outputs can have a separate mix of Ellie's voice and guitar, if I wanted to adjust that, or my guitar and the drum machine. So I just pressed those, adjusted them with the big knob in my mix. But now Ellie is going to want to hear more of herself, right?
Yes.
Okay, so how would you do that?
So I make sure my headphone is selected,
yep.
And I know that it's selected because it's blue.
Yep.
I hit my input, and I just adjust the big knob and look at the meter level to know how much I have, and then I would obviously play and sing a little bit to test and see how it all sounds together.
Exactly. And when you're playing, if the light ever lights, if one of the input LEDs ever lights red, that means you've just got to like lower the output from your device there because it's kind of distorting as well. And you notice that after you press the blue button to adjust your input level, it eventually will turn off. And then it'll revert back to your headphone level because we want to make sure you've got instant access to your headphone level in case it gets a bit loud.
Yeah, perfect.